control of induction motor by using power semiconductor devices. Okay. So control of induction motor can be done by using these are the different type of techniques. By using these are the techniques, we have to control the induction machine. So AC voltage controller, voltage source inverter, current source inverter, and cycle converters and a PWM controller. Okay, AC voltage controller and voltage source inverter VSI, current source inverter CSI, cycle converter, and pulse width modulation controller. These are the different terms of techniques. Understood? These are the different type of techniques. By using these different type of methods, we have to control this speed of the induction machine. So mainly focusing on speed control. Okay, the speed main purpose of this controllers is control the speed of the wire. Our main this is the so what is the output of this induction machine? So induction motor, electric mechanical. Okay, this output mechanical. So we have to control the speed of the machine. So by using these are the different types of techniques. Okay, AC voltage controller, voltage source inverters, and current source inverters. Yeah, and cycle converters called PWM. Okay, in AC voltage controller, this by controlling the voltage, the speed of the induction motor can be controlled. Okay, by using in stator side, not rotor side. Okay, for stator side only. This AC voltage controller is used to control the voltage. You know well, this torque is proportional to V square in the induction machine. Am I right? Torque is proportional to V square in an induction machine. That means by controlling the voltage, the torque of the induction machine can be controlled, and then speed of the induction motor is controlled. So that's so there is a this is only for stator side and the rotor side. In next unit, so we'll discuss in the rotor side. Okay, for stator side, and then coming to the some introduction regarding to the induction machine. Okay, some concept regarding induction machine. Introduction to the induction motor. Okay, the main application of the induction machine is called motor only, not for generator. Okay, induction machine is the main application for motor applications, not for generator. Few applications are induction motor. Induction machine is just a generator. Okay, few applications is for example turbine. Wind turbine. Okay, but this the speed is asynchronous. Asynchronous means is not constant, is varying. That's why the for the cases who have generated electricity, this induction motor can be used as a channel. But so main application of this induction motor actually is called motor only. Okay, so generally so different type of applications we know well. So we will discuss later in coming slides. So what are the applications? What are the advantages and what are the disadvantages? Okay, induction machines and what are the different types of types? So only so here I'm recalling this already. We already studied in the next machines. Just I will recall this concept. The electrical machine that converts the electrical energy to the mechanical energy and the mechanical energy to electrical energy. You know that induction machine. This machine, electrical machine, electrical to mechanical or mechanical to electrical. For motor, electrical to mechanical. For generator, mechanical to electrical. One understood. Okay, your drives systems are mainly used in applications such as pumps. Okay, the drive system is mainly used in applications such as pumps, fans, paper, and textile mills. Okay, so these are the different type of applications. These drives, also electric vehicle and surveys of transportation also, elevators, servo and robotics, home appliances, steel and cement mills. Okay, so these are the different type of applications of these drives, electrical drives. Okay, industrial applications are generally classified into constant speed and variable speed drives. You know well, constant speed and variable speed drives. Okay, AC machines have been used in constant speed applications because conventional methods of their speed control have either been expensive or highly inefficient. That's why these AC machines are used for only constant speed applications. Okay, AC machines in that means induction machine is generally used for constant speed applications because of controlling is expensive and also highly inefficient. Control is expensive and also highly inefficient. So that's why these AC machines are limited to some constant speed applications. But the variable speed applications are DC. Okay. But the DC machines may prefer for variable speeders. DC machines are prefer for variable speeders. However, so main advantage of the DC machines are so higher cost, higher rotor inertia. These are the different type of applications. Disadvantage of DC machines are higher cost. The DC machine is higher cost and higher rotor inertia. Maintenance problems with the commutator and brushes. These are different type of disadvantages in DC machines. Okay. So, and however, DC machines have converters and control circuits are simple and machine torque response is very fast. But it's having some disadvantages, but some advantages also. These are the disadvantages, even though if the machine is having this type of disadvantages, so it's having some advantages also. DC machine drive converters and control circuits are simple and machine torque and response is very fast. Okay. So this some introduction regarding to the induction motor. Understood? And here, you know, well, induction motors are two types. That is called squirrel cage induction motor, slip ring induction motor. We already studied this concept. Okay. Squirrel cage induction motor and a slip ring induction motor. Just I recalling this all concept. Okay. Just try to listen this. And these are the advantages of the squirrel cage induction motor. Okay. Cheaper, lightweight, rapid construction, more efficient, require less maintenance, it can be operated in a dirty and explosive environments. These are the different advantages of a squirrel cage induction motor. And the disadvantage also is having some disadvantages. Okay. So every machine is having some advantages, not 100% delays. Some advantages, disadvantages. So that's why this squirrel cage induction motor is having some advantages and disadvantages like this. So moderate starting torque, disadvantage. Moderate starting torque of this squirrel cage induction motor is less compared to DC machine also. And also slip ring machine also. Moderate in starting torque. And external resistance cannot be connected to the rotor circuit. Okay, this squirrel cage is already short circuited with the end rings. So external resistance is not possible to connect to the rotor circuit. Okay. So internally short circuited by end rings, the rotor. But So external resistance cannot be connected to the rotor circuit. So starting torque cannot be controlled in the squirrel cage induction. This is the disadvantage. And some applications of squirrel cage induction motors are. Squirrel cage induction motors are used in lattice, drilling machines, fans, blowers, and water pumps, grinders, drilling machines, etc. These are some different type of applications of squirrel cage induction motor and advantages and disadvantages of this squirrel cage induction. And then coming to the slip ring induction motor. Slip ring induction motor. So it's having some advantages. It's having some disadvantages. Okay, and applications also. Slip ring induction motor advantages are the starting torque can be controlled. Starting torque controlled by varying the rotor circuit resistance. Am I right? The starting torque can be controlled by varying the rotor circuit resistance. You know, well, this slip ring induction motor, the rotor is possible to insert the resistance by using slip rings into the rotor circuit. Am I right? By using slip rings, the external resistance is connected to the rotor winding. Is possible in slip ring induction by using slip rings. Okay, that means starting torque can be controlled by varying the rotor circuit resistance. Understood? Starting torque can be controlled by varying the rotor circuit resistance. And the speed of the motor can also be controlled by varying the rotor circuit resistance also. Okay. Starting torque can be controlled by varying the rotor circuit resistance and the speed of the motor can be also controlled by using rotor circuit resistance. The starting torque of this slip ring induction motor is very high. Am I right? approximately 250% 250 to 300% of the full load. 2.5 to 3% of the full load. 3.5 to 3 times of the full load torque. Starting torque of this slipping machine. Okay, some disadvantage is also there. Okay, so wound rotor machine is heavier. Wound rotor machine is heavier and high cost, high rotor inertia, high speed limitations. Maintenance and reliability problems are due to brushes and slippers. So these are some disadvantages. And the applications of the slipping induction motor. The slipping induction motors are employed only when the speed control or high starting torque is required. Okay. Examples are lifts, okay, hoists, cranes, elevators, compressors. These are the different type of applications of slipping induction motor. Am I right? And then, so let you consider here, this is the equivalent circuit of induction motor. This is the equivalent circuit of this induction motor. Equivalent circuit. So the equivalent circuit of induction motor is same as a transformer. Okay, the induction motor is called as the rotating transformer. This concept here, this is same as a induction motor stator winding, same as transformer primary winding, and induction motor rotor, that is called short circuited. Okay, the secondary side is short circuited, you know, scroll gauge induction motor. That means the rotor is same as a secondary winding of the transformer with short circuiting. Understood? So usually these are the different type of components. This called R1 is called primary winding resistance. X1 is called leakage reactance, primary winding leakage reactance. And this called magnetizing component, MU and watchful component. This is the no load component. Okay. This is called core loss component and magnetizing reactance. Okay. So under no load condition, these are all presented under no load condition. So this is called as a, so what is the difference here? Main difference is the transformer to here, induction machine. That is called core. In primary and secondary winding, there is a core. In transformer, primary and secondary winding, there is a core. But here, air gap. Only air gap is there. Am I right enough? So only air gap present in between stator and rotor. Based on induction principle, this rotor is rotating. Okay, understood. Whenever giving, when we are giving the power supply to the stator winding, the stator rotating magnetic field is rotating. Okay, at the starting there is a relative speed between stator and rotor, and then EMF induced in the rotor conductors because of that current is developed according to the Lorentz force. Okay, then rotor is trying to move in the same as a rotating magnetic field. Am I right? So here the slip concept coming to slip, one of the concept in here, but it's not there in the transformer. Okay. So this is the equivalent circuit of induction motor. So you know well, the rotor winding distance, the low, weakest reactance in rotor, okay, slip times of X2. Okay, it is standstill, so leakage reactance is called X2. Okay, it is a leakage reactance in terms of X2. Changing with respect to the load and also changing based on slip. Okay, so this is the equivalent circuit of induction motor, and then equivalent circuit of rotor. So you know, the rotor current is equal to the CGT, that is EMF induced in the secondary. I mean, that is called rotor is nothing but the CGT, whereby R2 square plus S times like this. This is the equivalent circuit of the rotor of induction motor. Understood? So this is called X2 low rotor leakage reactance, and R2 is called rotor resistance. So how to, this is a mechanical load, this is a mechanical load. How to convert the mechanical load to electrical, how to represent the mechanical to electrical, that is called, so R2 into 1 by S minus 1, am I right? So mechanical to electrical. So why means, why you are converting the mechanical to electrical means, so to find the performance characteristics, so to find the performance of the induction machine, the all parameters are converted into mechanical to electrical. Okay, so this already concept you are studying in previous semesters. And the torque equation of induction motor is called torque equation. 3 divided by omega s into v square by stator resistance plus rotor resistance by s whole square plus theta reactants plus and the rotor reactants whole square into R rotor resistance by S. R dash is called rotor resistance, R is called stator. Okay, here torque is proportional to V square. So based on this, the voltage can be controlled. By controlling the voltage, the torque of the induction motion machine can be controlled, and the speed is of the induction machine is controlled. This is the torque equation of induction machine. And next, maximum torque equation. Okay, so how to get the maximum torque? Slip rate maximum torque. By differentiating the torque with respect to S, dt by ds is equal to 0, and you will get maximum torque. So this is the maximum torque equation for motoring mode and a braking mode. Understood? Plus for my motoring mode applications and minus for and braking mode. So maximum torque is equal to 3d by 2 minus into v square by rs plus r root of r square plus xs plus r square. So for motoring mode, we have positive sign, and for braking mode, so this is the maximum torque equation of induction machines. And then starting torque, how to get the starting torque? So under starting condition, what is the slip? 1. So I mean, so the rotor speed is equal to 0. Slip is equal to ns minus nr by ns. That is called rotor speed is equal to 0 means ns by ns. That is called slip is equal to 1. Substitute slip is equal to 1. In this equation, you will get this type of equation. Starting torque is equal to 3 divided by minus into v square into rr divided by rs plus rr whole square plus x plus x. This is the starting torque of induction motor. Okay. And next, speed torque characteristics of induction motor. These are the different type of speed torque characteristics. Is having here torque versus speed. So in this stable region, unstable region, normal operating region. These are the different type of regions of induction machine, the speed torque. So here to here, this region is called unstable region. Okay, this region C to B. BC region is called unstable region. Yeah, stable region is called BD, and DA region is called normal operating region. Okay, so these are the different type of regions. Then coming to complete torque speed characteristics of induction motor. This interval, this is called motoring mode applications year to year. Okay, so year to year, this is called motoring mode applications. In motoring mode, so what is this slip range? 0 less than or equal to one. And motoring operations, the slip rate between 0 and 1. Okay. And the generating region is called, this is called generating region. In the generating region, slip is less than 0. Okay. That means slip is negative. That's generating region. And braking mode, that is called plugging. So slip is greater than 1. And so in between this region, 1 less than or equal to, slip less than or equal to. This is the complete characteristics of induction motor. Complete torque speed characteristics of induction. Then coming to the speed torque characteristics of stator voltage control. Speed torque characteristics of stator voltage control of induction machine. Okay, here you know well the one of the relation. Torque is proportional to V square. Am I right or not? Torque is proportional to the V square. So when speed of the 10% of reduction in voltage causes the 90% reduction in developed torque. Okay, induction motor speed can be controlled by varying the stator voltage. Okay, in induction machine, understood? Induction machine speed can be controlled by varying the stator voltage. This method of speed control is known as the stator voltage. Torque is proportional to V square. Am I right? Okay, this method is known as the stator voltage control. Yes, supply frequency is constant. This torque speed characteristics are based on by maintaining supply frequency constant. Okay, the torque equation indicates that the torque is proportional to the square of voltage. That is called torque is proportional to the square interval for same slip and frequency. Yes, for same slip and frequency. Okay, small change in stator voltage result in relatively large change in torque. Small change in stator voltage, that is called only 10% change in stator voltage, causes the 19% reduction in the torque. Am I right? Torque is proportional to V square. So, because of that, there is a small change in stator voltage causes the large change in torque. Am I right or not? Understood. So these are the different type of voltage levels. So V, V1, V2. So here, so voltage maximum, V is greater than V1 is greater than V2. Understood. So the torque is proportional to V square. So that's why when we are increasing the decreasing the voltage, so V, V1, V2, like this voltage decreasing, this is the starting torque of the induction motor as it changes very much. But slip rate maximum torque remains constant. So because of this frequency maintained constant. Am I right or not? By maintaining the frequency, so we are finding the these are the by maintaining the frequency, this torque speed characteristics are like this. You are maintaining the frequency by changing the voltage. This color stator voltage control method for this speed torque characteristics. Okay. And then next, this is control of induction motor. So there are different type of methods are there. Methods for speed control of induction motor. Okay,